See that right there? Right there, that's it.
Ah, I can't wait to see what it is.
There's treasures to be found. Let me show you.
Are you a Creek Geek?
Alright guys, I'm out here at this farm property. Charlie Harley was gracious enough to get us permission out here. And we got some special guests. I got Sean from Berks County Metal Detecting. We got Philip and Knox from Metal Detecting NYC out there. And we got Merrill.
Hello everybody.
Also from Metal Detecting NYC. We're excited to see what we can find out here.
Yeah. It's going to be a great day.
Sweet.
Well, first off, I just want to say how grateful I am to get an opportunity to hunt with these gentlemen. If you don't know, Sean from Berks County Metal Detecting, really great guy. He's all about metal detecting. He eats, sleeps, and breathes it. The guy's very passionate about what he does. Charlie Harley with Heritage Relic Hunters, he was nice enough to get us on this beautiful Pennsylvania farm property. Nicest guy you ever want to meet. And then the Metal Detecting NYC guys, I mean, these guys drove 3.5 hours to come hunt with us. And if you've ever seen Merrill's videos, I mean, the guy's friggin' hilarious. Philip the Knox brought us all sandwiches and drinks. I mean, it just shows you the type of people these guys are, and I feel very, very grateful to have the opportunity to hunt with them. I just wanted to get that out of the way. Enjoy the video. Also, if you want to go ahead and check them guys out. I'm going to include the link to all their channels down below. Just look in the description. Go ahead, stop in, give them a like, give them a subscribe. Like I said, great bunch of guys. Thanks.
I've got something that looks like it'd be a large scent or some sort of large copper. I don't know if you guys can see that right there.
It's a pretty sight to behold.
I don't know what this could possibly be, but here we're gonna figure out what it is.
A little bit smaller than a large scent.
You think so?
It could be a hand scent or maybe a big button. I don't know.
I don't think it's a button. I think this is a coin for sure.
It's British from the. I'm guessing.
Because it's so thin, right?
Thin. Yeah.
We're all guessing right now.
All right. Let me hit this with a toothbrush. And we're going to find out what it is. I'm thinking you might be right. I don't think it's a large
scent. Okay, so we determined, we're pretty sure this is a King George coin. So we're looking at 1700s all day. All day 1700s. You can kind of make out the bust facing left. I'm going to bring it home. We're going to play with it some more and try and get an actual date and maybe a little more detail off it. But I'm pretty sure that's what this is. Let's see how thin it is. We are on the 1700s goods. Yeah. That's crazy. All right, so I'm out here hunting here. It's Philip the Knox, right? We're showing off our stuff. This guy, look what this guy has in his hand. Get the fudge out of here. Look at that.
I guess that's a pretty tobacco.
Oh my goodness, man, that is a killer. You guys are on it today. Congrats, man. That's one hell of a find. Alright, Merrill here says he got something awesome. Let's see what he got in his hand.
I'm thrilled my day is made. It's a half cent.
Let's see if I can get the zoom in here properly. Dude, look at that.
That is so cool. Now that's considered the draped, right? That's a draped bust.
Yes, I think so.
What?
Either late 1700s, early 1800s.
That
I
is
believe.
Gorgeous. I wonder if you can get if that'll clean up. I can actually see some detail in there too.
I'm so
I see Liberty.
To clean it, but yep, I will
and
give
be,
it a try.
Yeah, be real careful. Maybe with a oh man, I could see some detail in that man. I think with a maybe a toothpick and
yeah,
you might be able to pull out some detail. Yeah, be real careful, but. Got some silver down here. Gonna do the reveal right now, see what it is.
Yeah, I think you're right. Oh.
I don't want to rub it too much. People freak out when you rub silver.
Who cares? Well, that's a...
Oh, it's a Merc.
That's because I'm here. Oh my God.
Are you the Merc guy?
That's the coin that finds me.
It's a Merc. Hey,
there you go. Congrats.
I think it's a 1917. That's an older one, too.
That's an old Merc.
Good
check
stuff.
That out.
Yeah. All right, guys, I'm at this beautiful farm here, and I'm pretty sure I got myself another flat button. If I'm not mistaken, you'll see that right down there. Get it out of there for you so you can have a look at it. Get some stuff in the way. The lighting's a little funky, but it's all right. We'll figure it out. Yeah, it's definitely some sort of button, for sure. Trying to make out some detail on the front. I'm not sure, but it's definitely a button. I'll definitely clean it up and show you guys what it looks like. All right, guys, got my next target here. It looks like I got a fired musket ball. There is what that looks like to me. You see, it's smooshed on the side here and around over there. That's what I would say it is. Fired musket ball, definitely. Definitely old. All right, I'll keep looking. All right, guys, I'm not sure what exactly that is. I'm assuming we are on a farm here, so that could very likely be a piece of horse tack or something from a wagon. Definitely got some age to it. I'll ask Charlie about it. He might know more because he's more familiar with the farm properties. All right, I'll get back to you guys. Hold on to my damn phone. All right, man, so Philip the Knox here is living up to his name. He's killing it out here with the Knox. He just got the most gorgeous looking seated I've may have ever seen. Let me flip this thing over. I'm like afraid to even touch it. All right, hold on, guys, here you go. Check that gorgeous thing out. Oh my Lord. Oh, and I just dropped it. Actually, it looks nicer like that.
Put it right there in the dirt.
There you go. Right where it came from. But that is nuts. Man, you were having a day. You have days like this often?
Do I have days like this often?
Yeah. Holy. Does he even know? Did you yell to him?
No.
Holy.
He's on the other field.
Still,
she's a little.
I think it's plastic.
She's a little worn.
So,
1810 though.
Philip thinks he's got a half cent here.
You can clearly see the year 1810.
Good stuff. Oh, is that? I can kind of see the 10 down here. Yeah. Check that out. Up right there, I see the 10.
The toothpick.
Wow. See
if it's a classic or.
That is so neat.
Yeah.
That is so cool.
10.5 cents.
Killing it, man. Alright, guys, I just dug up this piece. I'm not sure what exactly it is. I'm assuming some sort of farm implement of some variety. And on the back here, it has writing on it. I'm not sure if it says Denier Co. or Denier Colorado and Cintio. I'm not sure what that is.
Guys, you know, I've got a large fired bullet here.
I'd guess that's what it was. Looks like it definitely impacted with something, for sure. All smushed in, and that's the end bit right there. All right, I'm gonna keep on looking.
All right, guys, so I'm over here doing some digging, and I got something pretty awesome. I don't know what it is, but it looks really cool. I think it might be a pin or a button, or I can't even pick it up, apparently.
What is that? That is so cool.
What'd you get?
I don't know.
Oh, wow.
What is some kind of intricate, ornate piece, right?
Yeah. Can I see that?
Yeah, go ahead.
It looks silvery, right? It's got to be some kind of pin or something.
Yeah, what is that?
I don't know.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Can't wait to kind of clean it up and see what all the details are on it.
Yeah.
Alright, guys, so I cleaned it up a little bit. I carry around a toothbrush with me. I don't know if you can make that out, but it looks like it has a bird on it. Some kind of ornate piece of jewelry there with a bird. Almost resembles a hummingbird.
Give us a like, that'll really help out the channel. And if you like the content, go ahead and slap that subscribe button. Thanks for watching. See you on the next one. Are you a Cree Geek?